So let us now move on to the classification of solids. So you consider sugar in one hand and say face powder or the talcum powder in the other hand. If you compare, you can see the difference very clearly. The particles, individual particles in sugar have different shape, but the particles in talcum powder do not have definite shape. So this is the two different types of, these are the two different types of solids. The sugar, which has definite shape, is called a crystalline solid, and the particle which do not possess definite shape are called amorphous solids. So we have two types of solids. One is amorphous solid and another is crystalline solid. So we mainly going to focus on the crystalline solid in this unit. The crystalline term has come from a Greek term called crystallos. Crystallos means clear ice. So when you see an ice cube, it's very clear, very transparent. So previously it was called as crystallos in Greek. Later, quartz stone, it's also like ice. It's a heavy particle. It also looks like ice. So that also called crystallos. And later, all solids which have flat, very regular, symmetrical arrangements, structure, are called crystalline solids. So now we can say a crystalline solid like this. In crystalline solid as well as in amorphous solid, there are atoms or molecules or ions. But when you compare the internal structure, we can very clearly differentiate the crystalline and amorphous solids. When you consider the arrangement of atoms or molecules or ions in a crystalline solid, see, these are the atoms or molecules considered. So these atoms and molecules or ions are arranged like this. What I mean is, these particles are regularly arranged in a definite way. Whereas in amorphous solid, the molecules or atoms are not that much regular. They are in this way, that is, in a random way they are arranged. So this is a very important difference between crystalline and amorphous solids. So crystalline solids, the atoms or molecules or ions are regularly arranged, whereas in amorphous solid, the regularity is missing. It is somewhat random. So this regular arrangement is in long range. What I mean by long range, if you take a small crystal, all the particles are arranged regularly. If you take a little bigger, even in that, the molecules are arranged in the same regular way. Even if you take a very large crystal, in this also, the arrangement is followed. That is, long range order is maintained in the crystalline solid. What about amorphous solids? In amorphous solids, there may be regularity in the arrangement of the molecules, but it is not long range, it is short range. That is, mostly the molecules or atoms in amorphous solid are randomly arranged. So whenever you have a regular arrangement, the potential energy is minimum. So in crystalline solid, the molecules possess minimum potential energy. So this is the main difference. But in our textbook, the difference between crystalline solid and amorphous solid are very clearly given. So you can differentiate them. So